especially if you've got your Bible, turn with me to the book of Exodus, chapter number 12 this morning. I don't really want to preach this, not that it's hard or anything like that, but it's kind of silly in my mind, and I don't want to, but that part of that song they were singing is just trust and obey. That's what I'm going to do this morning. But the book of Exodus, chapter number 12. And I want to read verse number 32 through verse 41. And there's a purpose behind all this reading. But the book of Exodus, chapter number 12, in verse number 32 through verse 41, the Bible says this. It says also, take your flocks and your herds, as ye have said, and be gone, and bless me also. And the Egyptians were urgent upon the people, that they might send them out of the land in haste. For they said, we be all dead men. And the people took their dough before it was leavened, their kneading troughs being bound up in their clothes upon their shoulders. And the children of Israel did according to the word of Moses, and they borrowed of the Egyptians jewels of silver and jewels of gold and raiment. And the Lord gave the people favor in the sight of the Egyptians, so that they lent unto them such things as were required, and they spoiled the Egyptians. And the children of Israel journeyed from Ramses to Succoth, about 600,000 on foot that were men besides children. And a mixed multitude went up also with them in flocks and herds, even very much cattle. And they baked unleavened cakes of the dough, which they brought forth out of Egypt, for it was not leavened, because they were thrust out of Egypt, and could not tarry, neither had they prepared for themselves any victuals. Now the sojourning of the children of Israel who dwell in Egypt was 430 years. And it came to pass at the end of the 430 years, even the selfsame day, it came to pass that all the host of the Lord went out from the land of Egypt. Father God, Lord, our most gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, I've read this scripture, and Lord, I'm here, and I want to preach your word. I want to be a help to somebody today. And Lord, you know I've tried to get out of this and all like that. But Lord, if it's what you want, it's what I want to do today. And Lord, I ask you to give the message, Lord, it's needed, that might be a help to somebody today. Please forgive me where I failed you. Come short of the glory of God. Lord, if there be one here today that's lost and undone without you, Lord, I ask you to forgive me, that you would save them. But Lord, if there's anything in my life shouldn't be there, Lord, I ask you to forgive me of it. But Lord, please, please, please help me to be a help to these your people today. In the name of Jesus, I want to pray. And amen. Today, you may be seated this morning. And I want you to take a look with me, and we'll kind of go down through here right quick. In verse 32, it says, take your flocks and your herds. And then there in verse number 34, it says, and the people took their dough before it was leavened, their kneading troughs. And then you come down to verse 35, and it said, the children of Israel did according to the word of Moses, and they borrowed of the Egyptians jewels of silver and jewels of gold and raiment. And then you come down to verse 36, and the Bible says, and the Lord gave the people favor in the sight of the Egyptians, so that they lent unto them such things as they required, and they spoiled the Egyptians today. And I guess it was Tuesday, I was out on my mail route, and one of the first couple houses that I had to stop at, there was a thought come to my mind, and And I stopped and I kind of giggled about it a minute, and I thought, Lord, I ain't going to make me preach something like that. But I wrote down a few little notes about it and all like that. And then I thought, I got them wrote down right there. And then a little bit later on in the week, I thought that I had somebody to come preaching this morning, but it's next Sunday. And so I didn't even think about it, but then this just kept coming back to me and back to me and back to me. And the thought that's on my mind is lessons from a box. And you look at this, and these people, they had some stuff that they had to pack up. And they had some stuff that they had to get out of Egypt today, friend. And they had to get this packed up and packed away. And some of them was probably carrying it in their hands. But there again, some was probably putting things in wagons and so that they could carry it out of Egypt today, freeing them. And so I began to think about me being on my mail route, but also these people in the Word of God today, friend, and how that they had this stuff and they had to get it from Egypt to the Promised Land. They had to take it from way over here today, and we just went through some stuff that they had, and how that they had these herds and they had these flocks, and they had to herd them right along, and then they had this gold and this silver and this raiment, and they had to do something with it today, and they had to pack it up and all like that today, friend. And so I begin to think about lessons from a box today, friend. And you know, and thinking about moving and things like that, times that I have in my life today, friend, each one of those boxes, they've got a purpose today, friend. And this is where we put our dishes at. This is where we put our towels at. This is where we put our cleaning supplies at today, friend. And all those boxes has a purpose today, friend. And you know what? Me dealing with lots of boxes, amen to God, friend. I might not know what their purpose is today, friend, but the one that orders them today, friend, knows what they ordered them for today, friend. Amen. In church, I want you to know you've got a purpose today, friend. And I can't tell you what your purpose is just as well as you can't tell me what my purpose is today, friend. But each one of us today, friend, we've got a purpose that we was putting this life for today, friend. Amen to God, friend. I tell you today, I know some of you are in school and you're studying to do a specific trade and all like that. And then you've got a job in the church to do and all like that today, friend. And you've got a purpose in this life today, friend. And so many times we go around and we think, amen, I'm useless and I ain't no count and I'm just a waste of space and air today, friend. But I want you to know today, friend, you've got a purpose in this life today, friend. And over there in 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 18, it said that God put each one of us, amen, in the body as it pleased him today, friend. I'm telling you today, friend, amen, those boxes have a purpose today, friend. You have a purpose in this life today, friend. I'm thankful today, friend, that I know the purpose that God has put me in this life for. I know, amen, why? Because I've sought it out today, friend. I've sought out the purpose. purpose in my life today, friend. Oh, church, let me encourage you today, friend. You're not just useless. You're not just a waste of space and air today, friend. Amen. But you've got purpose today, friend. Amen. Some of you are taking care of elderly. Amen. Some of you work. Amen. In chicken plants. And amen to God. But whatever it is today, friend, you've got a purpose in your life. Amen. You mean something to your family, and you mean something to this church, and you mean something to each one of us individually today, friend. And you bring, amen, a specific help to the body today, friend. Amen to God, friend. But these boxes, amen, they had a purpose. Church, you've got a purpose today, friend. You know what else today, friend? I tell you today, a lot of my days, amen, for an hour or so, amen, I played Tetris with boxes in my vehicle today. I got to fit them in there just right. Because heaven forbid I had to make two or three trips today. But you know what? I'm packing up to go on vacation, or I'm packing up to move something from one place to the other today, friend. I got to pack them things in there just right today, friend. And you know what? These boxes, they had to be in order today, friend. Amen to God, friend. And I tell you what, church, listen, you know what? I tell you today, I know I'm a little quirky and things like that, but ain't it good knowing that your life is in order today, friend? Ain't it good knowing today? Amen, I've got my system laid out. I know how I'm going to pay my bills. Amen, ain't it good knowing today, friend, that everything between me and God is all right today, friend? Ain't it good knowing today, friend, that everything between me and my brother is right today, friend? Amen to God. You got to get them boxes in order today, friend. I'll tell you today, sometimes you got to lay it a long ways. Sometimes you got to stand it upright. Sometimes you got to lay it down on the bottom, amen, and put other things on top of it today, friend. But you got to get it in order today, friend. I'll tell you today, friend, amen, ain't good, amen, when you got a workspace and you know I got this right here and this right here. Amen. It's like a woman in her kitchen. A man don't know where everything goes, but she knows. Amen to God. And then a man in his garage. She don't know where it's at. And she gonna come mess it up until she finds it. Amen to God. But if she'd said, "You want you go get that," then you go get it. Amen. You know where it's at. I'm telling you today, friend, listen. Ain't it good having things in order today, friend? Let me say this. If you're here this morning, amen, and listen, listen, and things ain't just exactly in order, I want you to know, amen, listen, God can help get them in order today, friend. Amen, God can help get your life straightened out today, friend. God can help put you where you need to go today, friend. You know what? A while back, I had a big package. Amen to God. Amen. And I couldn't fit it in my vehicle, so I throwed it up top. Amen. And I throwed my straps over it, and I thought that thing's good and secure. But you know what? Today, friend, I got going up the road. Amen. Then all of a sudden, the straps come loose, and the box came off. Amen to God, friend. And I didn't realize it until I'd done a work for but you're secure in him. You're tied down in him. He knows where you're at in him today, friend. Amen. And if your life ain't in order, you can get it there today, friend. Amen. By him today, friend. Amen to God. I'm telling you today, friend. Listen, he ain't some big dummy like I am today, friend. Amen to God. He don't just think stuff like I do today, friend. But he's sure and he's steadfast today, friend. Amen. He knows how to work a ratchet strap too today, friend. Amen. But listen. Amen. Listen, amen, you have to be in order today, friend. You know what? John the Baptist came preaching, repent, for the kingdom of heaven's at hand. Jesus came preaching, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Amen. And you can get your life in order today, friend. Amen to God. Listen, let me say this. Amen. Listen, the little one packing the vehicle has a plan. Amen to God. Listen, I can only fill up this much space. I've only got this much room in my wagon today, friend. Amen to God. I want you to know today, just as you've got a purpose in life, amen, God has a plan for your life today, friend. God has a plan for your life today, friend. You know what? Most of these Israelites, they were setting out and they didn't know where they was going today, friend. But they knew there's a man out there that's heard from God. Amen. And we're going to follow him today, friend. But I want you to know, listen, amen. God knew the direction that they needed to go in their lives today, friend, and everything would be all right if they just follow him today. Sure, they got a little thirsty sometimes. Sure, they got hungry. Sure, they ran into the Red Sea today, friend. Amen to God. But listen, God come through and he opened up the Red Sea and they walked over on dry ground. Listen, they walked over and then they begin to murmur and complain. But God sent the manna and God sent the quail. Amen. Sure. Just like that. Listen, they had shoes and it wouldn't wear out today, friend. They had clothes and they didn't wear out for 40 years today, friend. God had a plan for them today, friend. And I tell you today, he's got a plan for me today, friend. He's got a plan for you today. I tell you, I was talking to Tiffany the other night, going up the road, and I was talking about me in church work 10 years ago compared to me in church work right now. And you know what? Looking back, I can see a growth today, friend. I can see what I'd have done then, and I can see what I've done now. Listen, my principles ain't changed. My other scripture ain't changed. Amen to God, but listen. Listen, I feel like I'm walking closer than I was. Amen. Why? Because he has a plan today, friend. And in your life today, kids, amen, some of you, a lot of you, amen. George said there's six kids. Listen, here this morning, and you're in grade school. Amen. About to be in high school and things like that. I'm telling you today, friend, don't listen to this one and listen to that one. Amen. But listen, draw near to God. Pray. Amen. And read God's word. And be here today, friend. Amen. And And you know what? The closer you get to God, you know what? Amen. The easier it is to know what His plan is today, friend. Let me encourage you today. I know they say follow your heart, follow your dreams. Amen. But I'll tell you today, friend, your life will turn out a whole lot better if you'll just follow the Lord and seek His face. Why? Because He had a plan. Listen, from a box today. Listen, I'm the box today, friend. You're the box today. He's got a plan for us. Amen to God, friends. You know what else? Amen. Amen. You don't know what you can handle. Amen. Until you're on the other side today, friend. I'm telling you today, you never know what's in the box today, friend. You know what? I've drove up to people, and I've scanned their packages, and I've handed to them. And they said, what in the world is that? I don't know. But you know what today, friend? Yeah. Amen. Listen, you know what? We go through things sometimes, and boy, we think it's the end of our life today. Oh, I don't know how I'm going. Listen, and then a week later, a month later, listen, you come out on the other side of it today, and looking back, you say, man, I don't know how I got through that today. Listen, you don't know what's inside of you. Amen to God. Until you get on the other side today, friend. And you know what? In this Christian walk of life today, friend. Amen to God, friend. Listen, we think, I'm not going to make it through this. We think, I can't overcome this. Amen. But listen, we got to unction of the Spirit. We got something that keeps driving us forward. Amen to God, friend. You know what today, friend? Listen, they ain't many times that I've got to see, amen, what people've got in their boxes today, friend. Listen, it ain't hardly ever happened today, friend. Amen to God, friend. But listen, He knows what He put in you today, friend. Amen to God, friend. And when you got dark days ahead, He knows what's in you today, friend. And when you got hard times ahead of you today, He knows what you've got. Oh, listen, what you've got in you today, friend. Amen to God. Why? Amen. Because He ordered you the way you are. And listen, He put you in. He paid the price for you. Amen. He paid the price for you today, friend. He ordered you that way today, friend. Oh, church, listen. We think, how am I going to make it through this? I don't know what I'm going to do. I don't know. I don't know. And life's so full of questions, ain't it? And life's so full of fretting and worrying and all like that today, friend. But listen, He knows what's in the box today, friend. Listen, they had jewels, they had gold, they had silver, and then except they spoiled the Egyptians today, friend. Listen, they come out with stuff. Amen to God. And listen, I'm telling you today, church, listen, He knows what's in you today. And because it's Him that's in you today, friend. It's Him that's in you today. And I tell you, it seems like I've been preaching on that part for a little while today, friend. And listen, you need to realize today, friend, that listen, you're not counting on yourself. You're not trusting in yourself. It's not the strength that's within you that's getting you through. But listen, it's Him today, friend, that's going to get you through today, friend. It's Him that's going to get you through today, friend. Oh, church, listen, greater is He that's within you than he that's within the world today. I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me today, friend. Strengthens me today, friend. We are more than conquerors through Christ that loved us and gave Himself for us today. today, friend. Lessons from above. You might not know what you can face and what you can go through, but he does today, friend. And listen, you know what? He's looking for you to get home. He's looking for you. I'll tell you, I ordered a jacket a while back and I wore it bad. And I tell you, I kept going online and I kept looking for that thing. When's that thing gonna get here? When's it gonna get here? And I ordered Mama something for Christmas and it took a month for that to get here, but I kept looking and I kept looking and I kept looking. Amen. I'm telling you today, you know what? He's looking on you today, friend. He's looking on you. Going to get you home today, friend. Going to get you where you need to go. You know what? There is a destination for them boxes, for this stuff they packed up. There was a destination. Listen, the destination wasn't the Red Sea. The destination wasn't the middle of the desert today, friend. Amen to God, friend. But the destination was the promised land today, friend. And I tell you today, church, listen. The destination ain't down here. Oh, church, listen. Listen, if you've been saved, amen, the destination's way up there today, friend. Amen, it's in God's beautiful city today, friend. I'll tell you today, I'm thankful. Hey, you know what, today, friend, some people get their packages before their time today, friend. I'll tell you, listen, I don't want to get there before my, I'm looking forward to going today, friend. But I don't want to get there before my time. But they sometimes in life, people disobey God and all like that today, friend. Amen. And they get took out before their time. Amen. But I want God, amen, to use me all the way up until that day that is my final day today. You know what? I told Mama this yesterday, but you know what? I was coming up the road the other day and it just hit me. I am halfway through my 70. I'm halfway through it today. And I tell you, it was kind of like a gut punch today, friend. I wasn't worried about it today, friend. But listen, amen, if all I've got is that amount today, friend, I'm halfway there. But I'll tell you today, amen, I'll tell you today, I want to be all that God wants me to be. I want to go where he wants me to go. I want to do what he wants me to do. I want to be what he wants me to be. Why? Because I know there's a destination. And you know what? Them boxes, listen, they get shipped out from your house and then they go to the post office or FedEx and they sit there for an hour or so. Then they get on a truck and then they go to a big plant and then they go down some roly things and they get on another truck and go to a bigger plant and then here and there and here and there. And they finally get back to your house. Or wherever you send them to. And ain't that the way life is today, friend? There's all kinds of twists and all kinds of turns. And amen, sometimes you're on an airplane and sometimes you go through a tunnel today, friend. Amen to God. But realize today, friend, there is a destination. There is a destination. And I tell you, I'm going. I saw there's something the other day. I think Tiffany's looking at face page or something. Or maybe it's on the news. I don't know. But there's a letter that had been out for like 80 years. And I tell you what, normally it don't work that way. But I tell you today, friend, normally it's there. But I'll tell you today, friend, listen, church, there is a destination. And it's that beautiful city of God. And I'm going one day after a while. I'm going. Why? Because I'm one of his little boxes. I'm one of his little boxes today, friend. But you know what? I'll say this, and I'll be, let me say this. And I'm trying to get away from this part, but you know what? Those people driving them wagons and walking and carrying them boxes and stuff, it wasn't just about the package. Do you know what? They had to look out for their safety. They had to look out for if they was going to eat something, or they had to look out and know it's about that time to bed down and things like that. And you know what I even thought about delivering boxes today. You know, it ain't just about the package today, friend, but you know what? I got to worry about driving. I got to worry about people's letters and Christmas cards and birthday cards and things like that. And listen, it ain't all about you today, friend. Amen, my life. I take up a big portion of my life today, friend. But listen, amen, there's times that I got to give way to others today, friend. There's times I got to step back and say, in this situation, you're more important than I am today, friend. Amen to God. And I tell you what, today, ain't that a hard thing to come to grasp with? I'm pretty important in my life, but this right here is more important than me at this time today, friend. Amen. I'm telling you today, friend, listen, we're not the most important thing. We are important. You are important today, friend. But listen, we're to put others ahead of ourselves. He said, love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, soul, mind, and strength. And he said, love thy neighbor as thyself today, friend. I'm telling you today, friend, Jesus over there in John 13, amen, he went and he washed the disciples' feet today. Amen. And he said, happy are you if you do these things, if you put others ahead of you today, friend. Amen. It's not all about us today. Amen. But let me say this. There is a destination. You ain't going to the destination if you don't get on the wagon. You are not. Now listen, if you don't get on the wagon, you ain't going nowhere. And I tell you today, friend, if you're here today and you ain't never been saved, you ain't on the wagon. You may be a box, but you ain't on the wagon. Do you know what? In order to get on the wagon today, friend, you got to make yourself available. Make yourself known. It's pretty much like that box standing there saying, I want to get on the wagon. I want to get on the wagon. I want to be saved. I want to go to the destination. I want to know my purpose. I want my life to be in order. And I want to think about others above myself today, friend. Amen. I want to get on the wagon today, friend. And I'll tell you today, if you're here today and you're not on the wagon, amen, listen today, friend. You know, they sometimes, and I think people do it for a sick joke to me, but I'll get these little packages, and they got a label on the front of them, and they're white as could be. Do you know what? The rest of that package is black. And you know what? Sometimes it's just a little package, and it'll fall on the floor, or it'll fall down on the bottom of my little wagon, and it's black too. And you know what? I can't see it. Because it's black. Amen. Do you know what? I go scratching around and I find it today, friend. I'm telling you today, friend. I'm telling you today, listen. Amen. I you know what? God wants to be like that. You might be a little black little package today, friend. Amen. And listen, nobody can see you. Nobody knows where you're at today, friend. But I'll tell you what, you just let him start cleaning up. Cleaning up all around. And you know what? A lot of times in little black packages, they'll just flop right over. You're like, there's my package.
I'm telling you today, Fred, that package is saying, here I am. Put me on the wagon today, Fred. Listen, oh, Fred, I'm telling you today, he knows where to find you at. He knows right exactly where you're at, and he knows how to pick you up today, Fred, and put you right in line for your stop today, Fred. Are you on the wagon today, Fred? If you're here today and you've never been saved, I want you to know Jesus loves you, and he cares for you, and he's not willing that any should perish, but all come to repentance through Christ our Lord. What's that mean? He wants to put you on the wagon. Amen. And I'll tell you what, if you'll call out to him and ask him to come in your life and ask him to save you, he'll surely do that. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved today. Amen. Have you called out to him? Have you asked him to save you? Lessons from a box. Amen. From a box. You can get to your destination, but you got to get on the wagon. Amen. But if you're here today, maybe preacher, my life just ain't in order. You know what? Them boxes, I got to put them in order. I tell you, if I was just to take off and these Israelites, if they just throw them right into it, listen, they've been everywhere today, friend. But you know, I got to take each one of them one by one. Put them right where they need to go. Tiffany tells me she puts them in order and she writes them down today, friend. But I tell you, I just put them in order and I keep a watch on them. And I tell you that I got to do that with each one of them today, friend. And listen, I got some back behind the seat back here. And listen, it's in the back of my mind today, friend, where it's at today. But I tell you today, listen, one by one. I tell you what, that's how God deals with us today, friend, one-on-one today. And if your life ain't in order today, friend, you got to come talk to him one-on-one. If you ain't saved today, friend, you got to talk to him one-on-one, one piece at a time today. And I'll tell you what, he'll help you get your life in order. He'll help you get on the wagon this morning. As they come with a song this morning, I tell you, I tried to get away from this. I thought it just silly as could be today, friend. But I tell you, I'm thankful for what I put in my heart. And I'll tell you what, I'm thankful I've got a purpose. And I tell you, I'm thankful you can get on the wagon this morning. But I'll tell you what, you got to call out to him. You got to ask him to save you. You got to ask him to help you today, friend. Amen. And you got to ask him, put my life in order. Please, God. I hope it's been a help to as we stand as they sing this morning. If you need to pray, this altar is open. Won't you come get right with God today? Won't you come get saved? Amen. I tell you, it'd be a good way to start out a year getting saved and watching yourself grow through till this time next year, and then watching God do a thing in your life the next year. Lessons from a box today, friend. If you need to pray, this altar's open.